first of all, thanks to the whole team for arranging a meaningful discussion around a very relevant topic. That is something I am equally passionate about, the environment and the climate change. There are so many ways of looking at it. I think the earlier speakers, they have highlighted what is going not so good. And I'm sure this seems to be a passionate group of folks who is fairly well aware of what's going around in the world. So I'll rather not focus on the seriousness of the topic of why climate change is so important or so prominent, but I'll rather want to focus on the actions which we are taking here in Yulu, and hopefully we are building a generation. We are good at unlearning. And I think that is so important, that the mistakes of the recent generations which have been happening, we unlearn effectively and actually build a meaningful and a more responsible and a more satisfying future for the planet, and in this process for ourselves as well. So we all know climate change is happening fast. There is so much pollution in the air, which is leading to increase in, CO2 being one of the parameters. And this is leading to increase in temperature, that is leading to disasters. So as per one estimate, approximately 4 billion people out of the current 6.5 plus billion on this planet have suffered disasters. And disaster has a pretty serious definition in the last decade, which is a result of climate change. And in India, the quality of the air is quite poor. Delhi is in the news every winter, and now it is back. I think the index has been hovering around 1,200 lately. Of the most polluted city in the world, India ranks amongst the highest. As per one estimate, the top 10 all are Indian. And when all of this was happening, we could see a few years ago, hey, that this is not on the right track, obviously. And this is where I would like to introduce a discussion around Yulu, where my co-founder and the CEO, Amit, he decided to do something about that. And he brought all the three co-founders, that is myself, head operations for Yulu, and R.K. Mishra and Naveen Dachuri. Four of us came together in 2017 to make this dream come true. What we do in Yulu is to basically provide a shared system for using technology through an app for our small form factor scooters, the Yulu Miracle, which I'm sure quite a few have tried yourself, and if not seen. And for the first and the last mile commute, we are targeting for short distance commute only. This is a pretty interesting product we had, because in a way we were absolutely bang on time. And this is electric, so this is also eco-friendly and serves the purpose in so many other ways. As one thing I think I would like to share as statistics is that of all the modes of commute, electric is by far the most efficient, because there is least wastage in the design of the engine itself, of the motor. If you compare there with an IC engine, the internal combustion engine, which is a diesel or a petrol, not even half the energy which the fuel has actually gets utilized in that engine. And that is creating fumes in our atmosphere. Especially when you're moving at lower speeds and moving from lower to higher speeds, the wastage proportion increases all the more. This is not the problem which electric has. And which is where, as responsible citizen, I think it is very important that we all move in that direction faster. Talking about being action oriented, there is a lot which is being talked about right now. At the same time, the government policies and this new generation is actually so inclined to make this change happen. And it is on all of us to make sure that we take the right step, we choose the right product. And this is where the Yulu comes as a cusp. It's not only electric, but it's also shared. And owning an asset is of course a requirement if it really deserves to be. But when the same asset, when the same resources are shared, that creates less stress on the environment. And that is one of the ways to actually protect the environment and the actions we can take. So this is where we come as a product, where you might have seen in Delhi and so many metro stations. Now I'm about to talk about how we made this happen. So We are a very passionate set of folks in Yulu. And when we started this idea to how to solve this problem, it was a pretty formidable problem. Asset safety on the road. So much of asset is lying on the road all the time. It's well-being, it's usability. And there are so many external factors which we do not control, you know, which we have to address so that the end customer is actually getting a good experience. And then they can actually go in the direction of not buying a vehicle or not picking up their own vehicle, rather using a Yulu, hop on it, go to a metro, and then on the other side, the last mile again, repeat the same stuff. And we actually use a lot of technology to solve this problem, not only for asset safety, but also for making sure that the assets are clean and they are always functional in the right way. We have a strength of more than 200 employees in our office and more than 500 people on the field. These are people who have moved cities from different parts of the country, as far as Northeast, from UP, Bihar, Andhra, to cities like Bangalore, Mumbai, and Delhi NCR, where we operate. And these people are equally passionate about this. And one interesting story I would like to share here is it's not only the general environment in context of climate change, but it's a broader environment also where a Yulu story resonates with a common man. I remember when the starting day is when we used to go out on the road just to understand how the technology part is working, how the process is working, and how we actually take it to the next level. I came across a security guard in one of the buildings where one of our Yulu customer had parked his bike. And I just went there to make sure that the location was right. And I happened to speak to him. And he said, "Sir, yahan nahi, wahan pe rakha hua hai, blue color wala aapka bike." And I saw a spark of rather a shine in his eyes when he talked about the product, which he hadn't used himself yet, but he was clearly aspiring to. And then I probed him and I realized the reason he felt so good about the product is not that that the product is environmentally friendly, but it's also affordable. And the same product he actually saw his friend, another security guard in the building, using it. And at the same time, the CEO of the company they were working for was also using it. So that is something which gave him a sense of, you know, empowerment that, hey, sir bhi same use karta hai aur hum bhi same use karta hai. So I think as a society, we are looking at practical and doable solutions. And if we create the right product, which is at the right place at the right time, I think this unlearning thing is very much in the air. And if I look at the way our Indian ethos are in particular, I think we are all set to go in the right direction. We're taking the right steps and making this a next step towards going in the right direction towards the environment. And coming back to Yulu now, so somebody asked me, so, hey, you take care of your assets, you make sure they are not stolen, but how do you keep them charged? Everybody wants to use the bike at the right place and at the right time, but they need to be charged sufficiently. So in Yulu, our team actually created an infrastructure, a whole network of charging stations where we collaborated with various entities like in Delhi with the Delhi Metro and other so many mom and pop stores, where we placed our small charging boxes, which are of the size of a refrigerator, more or less, which plug into a standard 15 ampere socket, which are there at our homes, and which helped us to make available the charged batteries at all locations of the city where our customers actually need the bikes at. This helps us to basically keep the time taken to swap the batteries from those charging stations into our miracles in a least amount of time. And it is this one thing which has really helped us to scale our business as fast as we have been able to till now. And besides that, I think other things which have been of much help has been the form factor for the bike. As you might have noticed, that this bike only runs up to 25 kilometers per hour, and it's small in size, and it has been a very deliberate choice. And why this has been is that this helps us to make sure that the bikes are available at the right place. And we do that by often moving the bikes of artificially in our trucks from one location to another. The speed limit of our Yulu bikes also helps us to stay away from the certain legal requirements like necessity of having a registered number plate or a helmet for our users, which anyways we really want them to use, and we encourage that. The omnipresence of Yulu is very much also dependent upon the parking infrastructure. One thing which I think I should mention is what is helping us and startups like us to move faster has been one, of course, the drive towards the e-mobility. The government and the general public in general has been pushing towards e-mobility. There is far more awakening towards the need to move from fossil fuel towards electric. At the same time, there has been a phenomenal investment which has been made across the country in general for public transport. Very soon, there will be 45 cities in the country where there will be metros available. Delhi, of course, was one of the cities which showed light to the rest of the nation on how world-class metro infrastructure can be made available. And a product like ours actually marries very well, very good synergy with the metro. Access to technology has been one of the catalysts, obviously, where the common man has a smartphone, and there are apps which are not only helping to access Yulu, but so many payment apps, etc. So technology has been a big helper here. And last but not the least, COVID, this phenomena really pushed up a lot of people to become more aware towards the environment. And at the same time, this has pushed e-mobility a lot faster. This helped us in Yulu to not only be moving people, but also moving goods. During COVID, when home delivery became the norm, we as a business started a new vertical. And we realized that, hey, this was a big potential and how we can move not only move people, but also goods. So now Yulu has two pillars. And a lot of deliveries, especially in Bangalore, at the homes, are right now happening on a Yulu. And in the future, and also other cities as well, you will see this phenomena growing really faster. It's a challenging business, and but I think we have a pretty formidable team. We have a pretty passionate work culture, a can-do attitude, something we are very proud of. We have 4 million registered users and a lot more downloaded apps, of course. And we have done close to 75 million kilometers of, if I add all the trips all our customers have done till date, it's 75 million kilometers, and it's 9.3 million hours. And we have saved a lot of emissions happening. If people would have used Yulu, they would have used some other fossil fuel-based product. And the total saving right now accounts for around 7,000 metric tons, which is around planting 1 lakh of trees. Besides this, I think we also help in certain ways, in an indirect way. We not only have direct saving, as I said, through by reducing pollution, but because when people use a product like Yulu, they tend to create less congestion and less traffic on the road. And then that leads further to reduce emission indirectly on the road as well. It is less stress. Please do not underestimate the impact which stress often creates on a common man who's stuck in a traffic. He's often hear about such instances. And I think that is all I wanted to share about. And what we also see as in terms of collaboration, lastly to mention, is not only the metro entities, but the government authorities in general, like the railways and the Indian Post, those entities have also been collaborating with us. So I think the revolution towards electric mobility has started. Their realization towards needing to own less assets and use shared more has also started. Yulu being at the cusp of these two is now mobilizing the new generation to go in the right direction. So I think that is all I had to add now.